In this video, we are going to look at two initially similar waders, Curlew and Whimbrel. Both are large for waders and have stout legs, grey-brown bodies and distinctive down-curved bills. So how can we tell these two apart? As so often happens with two similar species, one is much more common and familiar, and being confident identifying this one, the Curlew, will greatly help us pick out the less familiar Whimbrel when encountered. Curlew is a common and well-known resident bird. It is big, with the body size approaching that of herring gull. It is found principally around our coasts and wetland sites in winter, when some 150,000 birds are found in the country. 100,000 pairs breed, and these are found in a range of habitats, from coastal to inland grass, wetlands, moors and uplands. The plumage in all seasons can almost be described as bland. Dark streaked grey-brown uppers, merging to a white belly. The face is plain, and the steel grey legs medium in length and stocky. The most obvious feature of Curlew is, of course, the beak, which is long and down-curved. Among the larger waders, this feature is shared solely with Whimbrel. It is worth noting, however, that relative bill length is sometimes quoted as an ID feature, but this can be very misleading, as bill length in both species varies with sex and age. With Curlew, however, the curve appears constant and gradual throughout the whole length of the bill. Whimbrel is a significantly smaller bird, with a body size about the same as a common gull. Whimbrel are much rarer. Only a handful are present in the winter, and some 500 pairs breed on mountainous bogs and moors in the far north of Scotland. But several thousand birds pass through on passage in April and May, and again in late summer and autumn. Field guides and illustrations always focus on the two brown crown stripes on Whimbrel, but in the field, without excellent views, these can actually be frustratingly hard to see. Whimbrel can sometimes seem surprisingly plain-faced, especially if you are expecting a stripy-faced beauty. If you do see the stripes and the apparent supercilium, then you have clinched the ID, although do be aware some Curlew can occasionally have unexpectedly obvious superciliums. Seems just to confuse us. Overall, Whimbrel gives the impression of a small, dark Curlew, and one of the best visual clues is that bill, which, unlike in Curlew, appears as a straight bill with a bent end. The curve is not even and continuous. Both species look similar in flight. Dark birds above, with a white rump and V-shaped back. If the apparent size isn't obvious or the bill can't be seen, one difference that seems to be constant in the field is that Curlew upper wings seem to grade gradually from the body colour to the darker outer feathers, whereas Whimbrel have a much more abrupt pattern, with the whole outer wing appearing much darker than the inner. Whimbrel also fly with much faster wing beats than Curlew, again a feature that is easy to pick out when you are familiar with Curlew. Since views of both species, considering their habitats, are rarely close enough to make out many details, you'll be glad to learn that there is something else that will help us identify these two species, and that is their songs and calls. Curlew are quite noisy birds, uttering calls on the ground and in the air. They make a range of sounds, but a distinctive, beautiful, melancholy curlewy is unique to this species and is indeed a characteristic sound of our wild habitats. Their contact or flight call is a single note, a drawn-out piping whistle, which to me always sounds distressed. Sometimes uttered singly, curlew also string together 3 to 5 of these notes with a slow rhythm. Whimbrel do make some similar sounds to curlew, but they also have a distinctive contact or flight call. This call, once known, will often alert you to the presence of Whimbrel, and it can sometimes be picked out from birds migrating high overhead. Again, it is a whistle, but it's less fluting, more confident sounding, not worried or distressed. Whimbrel often repeat this quickly as a series of notes, or even join it together into a trill. It may help to remember an old name for Whimbrel is Seven Whistler. If you were lucky enough to hear either species sing, again you can tell them apart. Curlew's song is a familiar, rising series of whistles which accelerate and merge into a beautiful bubbling trill. It's one of my favourite bird sounds. Curlew's song is evocative of all of our wild places. Whimbrel's song, likely only to be heard on the breeding grounds, starts in a similar manner to curlew, with those same rising notes. But it then descends into a rapid trill on one note, similar in fact to the call, and lacking the bubbling, fluty elements of curlew song. It can almost be described as stammering.